Why the fuck am I even paying you guys? What am I paying you guys? Obviously too much. Whores on the street get picked up by cops after a while. People start wondering, gee, look at that shape-shifting whore. And this is not something we need to draw a whole lot of attention to from any angle. The time is slipping through our knobby fingers. And the trap is hard on this one. We lose this, we lose everything.
Something's definitely going on here. Abandoned lot, that wasn't their base of operations. We need to follow them.
Let us not get our priorities mixed up here, Sam. We still need to ask among Jamie Smith's known contacts.
We can't just let this go. There's lives at stake.
We are currently on assignment until the captain tells us otherwise, unfortunately. I detect proximity, possible suspicious persons.
Right. Let's get out of here.
I'm putting Griggs number 5 on it. There's no need to get you mixed up in anything else.
Captain, we got a chance to take Kid Franklin red-handed, and
I don't want to hear it! 6, will you step outside, please? Out of earshot. We're in a bit of a mess right now, Sam.
To call this thing a mess doesn't even begin.
I've got protest groups, civil liberty unions, politicians. Senator Thompson himself is calling for an immediate investigation into the incident.
What is there to investigate? The gray bastard came at me with a knife, and I put him down.
Yeah, but every time you fire that super magnum of yours, the shot echoes across the whole damn city. And when the shit hits the fan, it all falls on me. The autopsy report shows 15 rounds. 15 rounds, Sam! You tore him apart!
Super magnum holds a lot of rounds.
Senator Thompson's actually asking why you even need to carry such a weapon. You could have a charger with a stun setting.
Ooh, and maybe I can turn in my handcuffs too. And then I can bring them in with kind words. If they know you're carrying with a stun setting, they're gonna take the kill shot. That's the way it's always been.
Sam, I need you on this for political reasons. I know you have problems coping with the real world, but we need to show the people that you actually care about the Greys. If you can't get this done in a short amount of time, then I don't know how long I'll keep these vultures at bay. They want your blood, Sam. They are rabid.
Let them take it from me in the street.
Any more excessive violence and I'm gonna take your badge. Without a shield, you won't have any protection. Dismissed.
Detective Sam Walters. All these years of service and my only reputation is as an alien-hating all-American cop with one foot in the grave. The other foot planted firmly up the ass of an alien. Took a lot to make me this way. The hell with it. Time to have a word with Harold.
Well, Mr. Fox, it looks like you've earned yourself a trip back to the moon first thing in the morning. Home, sweet home.
Are you gonna beat my ass, or are you just gonna stand there trying to scare me?
You got a smart mouth on you, Harold. Too bad. It's gonna cost you certain freedoms.
What? A bag of peanuts on my flight back to the moon? I know a guy at the spaceport that sells them out of a box.
No, Harold. I meant your ability to leave this place. You see, up until now, you've been tight-lipped. That beak you call mouth hasn't been spewing enough information that I want. Not enough to buy your way back in.
I don't even have citizenship. What's the point?
You were doing just fine till you flashed all that cash around those hookers. This affords you the chance to go back to doing what you were yesterday. All I need is to know what you make of this.
I don't even know you're gonna let me out of here.
6. Open the door. All you've got to do is identify this. I've ordered 6 to stand down.
They'll kill me.
Harold, I need to know what this is.
It's Janie's sister.
Janie had a sister?
Sandy. Sandy Smith. The Mafia wants her real badly. That's all I know.
Alright. Six, let him out.
Sam, I'm worried about the infraction you've caused letting Harold go without signing him out properly.
The captain can bitch about that all he wants.
Letting a known offender loose is very, very dangerous.
They will take him. He will tell them everything that we know.
I'm counting on it, Six.
Sam! Lovely day, isn't it?
Franklin, I didn't know you had the spine to appear during the daylight hours.
Like I said, Sam, for you. By the way, Sam, how's your neck?
Mother bites pretty hard.
You know, I'm putting my reputation as a hero to the great community on the line. I'm making an example out of you right now.
Threats to officers of the law are punished with the strictest of enforcement.
Shut the fuck up, Arnold. Officer Six, if that's your game face, Sam here's going to hit you, buddy.
Threaten me one more time, shit.
Sam, you know me. I don't like saying things more than twice. I'll cut you a deal though, Sam. If you turn in your badge and apologize to the community, I will publicly forgive you.
What kind of world do we live in when some punk fuck like him can threaten a cop?
It is all too easy for society to give in to the demands of the evil when they've been provided with drugs and sex.
Sadly, he was right. I went for cover. Six didn't see it coming.
March 31st, 2047, at exactly 12:23 p.m.
That was 5 minutes ago, Six. You rebooted when you got shot.
Oh, yes, sir. Suppose I did.
Six, you sound different.
I must have upgraded during the reboot.
Six, they're not going to let you
He wasn't a person. He didn't get a trial. No human rights. Just an asset to the department. No mention of his achievements, or all the good work he'd done for them. Artificial intelligence was our last triumph, and our last failure. He's as real as we are. I wonder if he has a soul. I had to call in a favor to get to talk to Six. When I got in there, it was like he was a completely different person. Six had evolved. The cold, logical mind had tried his best to show emotion was now an intelligent life form of feelings and thoughts. The humanity in him. I realized that another part of my own humanity had died with him. They were probably going to sell his body as police surplus. It's a rarity in any part of the world to see natural, unadulterated sunlight. It's possible for it to slip through the field, even if just for a split second, but not very likely. And I couldn't help but feel relieved. Feel like there was something out there, whatever it is, whatever you believe, it has the power to change the world. And then, just like that, it's gone again. And all you are left clinging onto is the hope that someday, you'll get to see it again.
Hello, Harold.
Hey, kid, what's up?
Talking all loud, are we? Harold. You are the biggest, greatest disappointment on this entire planet. And the moon, for that matter.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Harold, don't you dare lie to me. You know, I know they wouldn't have released you unless you told them something real good. So let's have it. Harold, what do they know? What do they know?
I told them about Janie's sister. I don't know anything about her, I swear.
What else?